for such a time as this, and the Lord God will hear us as we cry out to Him to give us names.
Amen.
At this time, we are just going to start blessing the name of the Lord, praising God, appreciating God, honoring God, exalting God, magnifying His holy name. Let's begin to thank the Lord. Let's begin to bless the Lord.
Magnify the Lord. I give you praises. I give you glory. I give you all the glory, Lord of hosts. Blessed be my almighty God. For there is no give you all the praises, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. Hallelujah. Blessed be my King of glory. What a mighty God, what a glorious minister. Father, we bless your name. You are great, you are mighty. Father, you are powerful. Father, we exalt you.
We pray.
In the name of Jesus. Amen.
We have one of our fathers on the line with us. Is actually going to open us up, Pastor Essen. So the media department should please look for him and unmute him. And we are going to be blessed tonight by the grace and the power of the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So please unmute Pastor Essen. You will see his name there. You see R. Essen. Pastor Essen, over to you, sir.
As soon as I'm on mute.
We can hear you. You are on mute.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Blessed Father, we thank you and we worship and adore you for our gathering together. We thank you for the privilege, so special, that we find ourselves in the kingdom of God. Father, we're asking, O God, according to your promise, that if my people that are called by my name will pray, will seek your face, will turn from their wicked ways, that you will hear from heaven and you will heal the land. Amen. Father, I'm asking, O God, as we lift our hearts unto you, that indeed your word will be true.
Amen.
That you will heal this land and give us, O God, the fruit of the blessing of the land, the glory of the land, the milk and the honey, not just for the carnal flesh satisfaction, but for your glory, for the purpose of the cross, for the glory of Christ in the salvation of men in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm asking, O God, that you come breathe at this time on us, and cause your glory to fill our hearts in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you and we bless your name, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Brethren, let's open our hearts unto the Lord and begin by blessing the Lord, by worshiping Him, by praising Him. The scripture says, praise ye the Lord, praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in the firmament of His power. Praise Him for His mighty acts. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. He says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. If you can breathe, you can praise the Lord. If you can breathe, you can praise God. If you can breathe, you can talk to God. If you can breathe, you can magnify the name of the Lord, the name of Jesus Christ. Blessed Father, we just thank you and we magnify your great name. Thank you for your faithfulness, O God. We thank you for thy great power, O God. Thank you for thy excellent kindness, O God. Thine, O Lord. Thine, O Lord. Thine, O Lord. Thine is the kingdom and the glory and the power. Father, thine is the honor. Thine is the excellency. Thine, O God, is the power. Thine is all. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we just thank you.
Give it glory. Glory and honor to the Holy
Spirit. Lord, we worship and adore you, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 The scripture says, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. And his greatness is unsearchable, unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another and shall declare thy mighty acts. If all 7.5 billion people on the planet Earth will open up their voice and will praise him into eternity, when all are gone, the Lord will still be qualified for more adoration. And so let's go bless his name for his excellent majesty, for his power, for his greatness, for his goodness, for his might, for his excellency, in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your heart, open your mouth. The Lord is too great. If you want to adopt the way the angels praise him, you should adopt that method of praising. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Listen, you remember Isaiah chapter 6. The angels know God and see God. They know him better than we do, isn't it?
Yes.
When Isaiah's eyes were opened and he saw the Lord sitting on the throne, you know what? How the angels were praising God? Holy, holy, holy is a thrice holy God. They bless him for his character, for his might, for his excellency, for his purity. His children should know what to say to him. And we are his children. Let's open up our mouth. Sister, brother, take this seriously, because this underlines everything else that we're going to be talking to him about today. That we know him, that he is holy, that he's mighty, that he's omnipotent, that he's omniscient, that he's omnipresent, that he's waiting to hear from us. Let's open our heart, let's open our mouth, let's bless the name of the Lord at the top of your voice, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's thank him, let's thank him, let's thank him for his power, for his power. He appeared unto Abraham and told Abraham, I am the Almighty God.
I am the
Almighty God. I am the Almighty God. I am the Almighty God.
The middle and the end.
Let's magnify his great name. Let's magnify his glorious name. Let's magnify his excellency. Let's magnify his majesty. He is the Lord. He is the Lord. He is the glorious king. He is the savior of mankind. He is the healer of mankind. He is the deliverer. He is the God that punishes other gods. He is the God that has told us there is no other. He said himself he went to search, and he knows everything, and he created everything. He said there is no other God in competition. Let's magnify his great name. Let's magnify his excellency. Let's magnify his power. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord God Almighty, you are glorious, you are excellent, you are mighty, you are powerful, you are omniscient, you are omnipresent. Hallelujah. You are holy, times holy, the thrice holy God, the Trinity, the Holy Trinity. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The maker of man and beast, the owner of the cattle upon 1,000 hills. Father, the silver belongs to you. Father, the gold belongs to you. Everybody else is a usurper that does not, Father, surrender and submit to you, O God, that you own everything, including our souls, including our beings, including our lives, including our time, including our talents, including our treasures, in the name of Jesus Christ.
And magnify your holy name, Lord.
Let me thank you. Oh Lord, rejoice in thy majesty.
Lord Jesus.
Rejoice in thy great power. God, all that will rejoice in thy excellency. Who is like unto thee? Who is like unto thee? Who is like unto thee?
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 The Lord has been gracious. The Lord has been wonderful. He was mighty in Abuja. In the spring, he was mighty in Calabar. He was mighty in Enugu. Let's bless his name. Let's thank him for all the signs and wonders, for all the mighty works, for all the things he has done. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for the souls that were saved. Father, we thank you for the people that were healed. Father, we thank you for the people that were sanctified. Father, we thank you for the people, oh God, that came into the kingdom. Father, we thank you for the people that you implanted, oh God. Father, we thank you for your work that is making progress, oh God. Lord, we thank you for the program, Lord, in Abuja in the spring. We thank you for the program, Lord, in Calabar. We thank you for the program that we just finished in Enugu, and we know, oh God, you still have more. There's still abundance in heaven. There's still glorious abundance in heaven. Father, receive our praises. Father, receive our adoration. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray.
Father, with the amen.
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 Bless the name of the Lord. Another opportunity is giving us a letter this month to bless us with another global crusade. This time around, the stakes are higher. This time around, we're expecting greater things. Let's just thank him for the privilege. Let's just thank him for the opportunity that is coming our way again, so that whatever problem was lingering, there should be a solution this month. There will be a solution this month. Any family going through any trial, any family going through a family situation there is a solution coming our way. Let's bless the name of the Lord for the solution that is coming this month. Let's thank God for this mighty power that is coming our way this month. Once again, let's magnify his name in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's thank God.
God.
Let's thank God for the crusade that is coming. Let's thank God for the great event that is coming. Let's thank him that his presence will be with us. Let's thank him that his power will be present to deliver. Let's thank him that his glory will be magnified in this event. Let's thank him that his excellency will reach to all four corners of the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's magnify his great name in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let's thank the Lord for preserving us, that we have opportunity to be with him and to fellowship with him and to be blessed by him once again this month. The Lord has preserved all of you all through the pandemic of 2020 unto 2021. 2021 is running to an end. The enemy didn't think you were going to be here, but God knew you were going to be here, and God has kept you till now. Let's open our hearts and mouth and bless the name of the Lord for seeing this day, for having this hope, for seeing this month, for seeing this year in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's thank the Lord.
You preserve, O Lord, everyone.
Thank you for your righteousness. You are the Lord, our righteousness. You answer prayer. Thank you, Lord, for your presence in this place.
Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him.
We are sent unto your throne. Lord, we grant our supplication.
Pastor Dada, please, can you take over?
Thank you, Pastor. Yes. Next person, please come in.
Jesus.
Please unmute Pastor Ochi.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank the Lord for the first session we just had. We want to open our mouth and begin to worship the Lord. The Lord again. We want to give the Lord all the praise, all the glory for the privilege We have to come before the presence of the Lord to seek His face, to call upon His name. Let's give God praise once more. We want to thank Him. We want to exalt the name of the Lord. Our God is worthy of all praises, worthy of all honor. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I read to us from Matthew chapter 9. Matthew chapter 9, and I'll read from verse number 35. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Then said he unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Jesus Christ, our Master, our Savior, our perfect example, there's no one like him. The one that led by example, the one that was not just about the word, but by action. Who understood the mission of the Father, who understand the heartbeat of the Father. He saw the people. He personally interacted with the people. He saw their living condition. He saw their needs, physical needs, spiritual needs, all kinds of needs. And what did he do? He not only mobilized the people, he went and he demonstrated it. And that is why in this session, we are talking about mobilizing ourselves, mobilizing the church. And getting us equipped and get ready and really charged to go out. This morning we heard from our Father in the Lord directly himself. The need of the moment, the need of the time. Want to open our mouth and begin to pray. Want to ask the Lord to give us the grace to have the eyes of Jesus. To see the people as Jesus Christ saw them. Want to pray that God will give us the mind of Christ. God will give us the eyes of Christ. God will give us the feelings, the compassion that Christ has. Why don't you open your mouth and begin to pray and call upon the name of the Lord and say, oh Lord, help me to have the eye to see as Jesus Christ saw the people, to have the mind that Christ had towards them. It's a heart of love. It's a heart of compassion. It's a heart that is touched by the challenges of the people, by the spiritual condition of the people. And when you look around you, wherever you are, you see the condition of the people, depravity. One to pray. Let's open our mouth and pray. Call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, help me to see the people as Christ saw them. Help me to see them as Christ saw them. In their condition, in their state, in their mind. Pray, call upon the name of the Lord. These are people that are lost.
We beseech you.
And God will give us the mind of Christ. God will give us the love of mind of Christ. Call upon the name of the Lord.
Oh,
call upon the name of the Lord.
Pray,
call upon the Lord. Will give you the love that Christ has for them. You will have that love. You will see them as they are. As people without a shepherd. Let's call upon the name of the Lord. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Christ saw them. These people, they need guidance. These people, they need direction. These people are lost. These people are hopeless. These people, they are looking for solutions. And they don't know how to get these solutions. But we know that there is a divine solution. And that divine solution is for the whites, is for the Hispanic, is for the Asians, is for the Africans, is for the Caucasians, is for everybody. And you and I have this word. You and I know that we can direct them to the place where they can have the final solution to their problems. You want to pray, oh Lord, you will use me. Oh Lord, you will use me as we are going now to mobilize ourselves and to challenge. Open your mouth and call upon the name of the Lord. Father, Lord, I will make myself available. I am an instrument that you use to redirect people. I am an instrument that you use to guide these people aright. I'm an instrument that you will use to focus and to direct these people to the Savior. They need the Savior. Call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, I am available. You will use me. I am available. You will use me. I will sacrifice whatever it is, time, money, talent, availability. Oh, Lord, I am an instrument you will use. The people are crying. They are looking for peace. They are looking for the Savior. They have needs in their lives, spiritual needs, physical needs, and they need a solution to their problems. They have gone from doctors seeking doctors' help when there's no help. They have gone to herbalists when there's no help. They have gone to farm leaders when there's no help. They have gone to various places when there's no help. We know there is a helper. We know there is a Savior. We know there is a Redeemer. We know there is one that we can point them to. But the Lord is looking for men and women that make themselves available to be used of the Savior. Father, just call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Whatever I need to do, by through social media, by physical contact, by words of mouth, by the Twitter, by whatever means available, that God, you will use me. I will do everything. I will put my personal commitment, I will put my personal ambition, I will put whatever I'm doing aside, so as answer the master's call, and do the master's bidding. Call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, help me, oh Lord. I need your grace. In this time of need, in this time, the Master, the Savior is looking for men and women to use. Lord, I am available. Lord, I'm available. Lord, I'm available. I will do everything. I will proclaim the gospel. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Pray for the Savior. Say, Lord, here I am. I'm available to be used of you. I will be used of you. Call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, have you used me? Use me. Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Even the Lord Savior, our Savior himself, he acknowledged that there are few laborers. He acknowledged there are few people, even though saved, are not available to be used. And if the Master will acknowledge that, are you going to answer the Master's call? Are you going to tell the Master, Lord, you can count on me. You can count on me. I can be dependable. I can be loyal to you. I am willing to do all things, knowing that this is the Master's call. The Master himself acknowledged, I said, there are few laborers. Brethren, are you one of those that have that the Master is looking for to use? Why don't you open your mouth and say, Lord, I have not done this well, but today I am repenting. Today I am doing everything. Today, through the week, I will mobilize. I will print out flyers. I will spend my money. I will go on Twitter. I will go on Facebook. I will go on Instagram. I will use the WhatsApp. Whatever I will do, I will put my personal ambitions. I will put my personal needs. And I will say, this is the Master. The Master said, I need laborers. Are you available? Are you willing to do the Master's bidding? Are you telling the Master, you can count on me? Are you telling the Master, you can depend on me? Are you telling the Master, here I am. I am available to be used of you. Open your mouth and call upon the name of the Lord. And say, Lord, I have not done well. I've not done well, but because of today, Lord, you can count on me. You can count on me to bring the food of God. Even at this global crusade, I will make sure I will look for them one by one. Two by two, I'm going to go out. I'm going to do everything. And I will not relent in my efforts. I will not be at ease as Zion. I will do everything the Master wants me to do. Open your mouth and call upon the name of the Lord. And ask the Lord for grace. Ask the Lord for grace. The Lord will count on you.
The Lord will count on you. The Lord is looking for men and women. Are you available? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? In the name of Jesus, call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Oh, yes, Lord, you can count on me. In this hour, you can count on me. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. It's a praying here for the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into the vineyard. And that's why we have come tonight to pray. And that's why we are praying on Wednesday. That's why we are praying on Sunday. We want to seek the face of God. We want to pray, Lord, you will count on me to pray, to intercede, even in my own private, not just for the regional prayer meeting, not just for the national prayer meeting, but I will personally give time to wait on the Lord. And I will pray and seek. I will pray and seek. I will call upon the name of the Lord, and the Lord will surely answer. Open your mouth and pray. I will give myself to prayers. I will give myself to prayer for souls of men. For souls of men. The souls of men that are perishing. The souls of men that are perishing. The souls of men that are looking for people that will witness to them. As the Lord, oh Lord, I will take time. Say, he that goeth forth and weepeth, he that goeth forth and weepeth, very precious seed, shall doubtless come again, we rejoicing and bringing his sheaves with him. That whatever you sow in tears, you will reap in joy. As you sow in tears, in prayers, in words of the Lord, you will reap in joy as the souls will come. Call upon the Lord that you will pray, you will seek time to pray. And seek the face of the Lord and pray endlessly in all our locations, everywhere you are. You're personally praying and you're crying unto the Lord. And God, you will depend. I'm depending on you. Help me. Through my life, I'm going to bring sinners to this program. I'm going to invite people, the one next to me, to this program. I will bring someone to this program. I cannot come to the Lord empty handed. Oh, call upon the name of the Lord. You will pray. Jesus Christ prayed. He said we should pray. You will pray. You will see. You will passionately give your heart and give your best for the Lord, for the Savior. In this crusade, proclamation and propagation of this gospel, the Lord will use you. You will project this program. You will promote this program. You will proclaim this program. Oh, great is the company of those that publicize this. Great as a company. I will be among the company. I will be among the company of publishers. I will be among the company of proclaimers. I will be among the company of the people that obey the Lord. The Lord will count on you. The Lord will depend on you. The Lord is counting on you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Father Lord, we call upon your name again. We ask, count on us, Lord. We will not fail you. Give us the grace. We are going to proclaim. We are going to declare. We are going to project. We are going to do everything possible to bring people to you. You bless the fruit of the work of our hands. And our labor will never be in vain. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
At this time, we're going to focus on praying for conversion. We're going to focus on conservation as well as for preservation. We know that the primary purpose of having a program like this is for sinners to be converted. The primary purpose is that they are not only converted, but they are also added to the church. The Bible says, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. And it's very important for us to really pray for the conversion of souls. We know that there is a poor devil there that does not want sinners to get converted. Jesus said, I will build my church, but the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. In Christ, he wants his church built. In the mind of Christ, he wants souls saved. In the mind of Christ, he wants people to be converted. He wants sinners converted. He wants backsliders restored. But that is not going to happen until we pray. The Bible says we have not because we ask not. And the word of the Lord encourages us, ask of me, and I will give you the hidden for your inheritance. and the uttermost part of the earth for your possession. We're going to pray for the Eden. We're going to pray for souls. We're going to pray that this divine solution for all crusade, we will break new ground in the number of souls that will be converted.
Amen.
More than Amen. We have ever seen. Let's open our mouths and pray right now. In the number of souls that will be converted, the Lord by his might and his power will bring them, will bring sinners to conversion. The Bible says that salvation belongs unto the Lord. He's able to save unto the uttermost. That the Lord will give us the hidden. Will give the hidden to us. Will give the hidden to Christ. We are ambassadors of Christ. The sinners will be converted. The sliders will be restored. The yoke of sin will be broken. The bondage of sin will be destroyed. And the people will come to know Christ. And the number of converts this time will be greater than most have ever seen. We will break new grounds in the number of converts at this time. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. Name Lord, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, I want you to really pray your heart out. The Bible says that God is not willing that any should perish.
Yes.
Because he's not willing that any should perish, he wants them to come to the knowledge of the truth through Christ Jesus. He wants them to be saved. He wants them to know the Lord. But the Bible tells us if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. In whom God of this world has blinded the minds of those who believe not. We're going to pray that all the blindfolding weapon of the devil to hinder souls from getting, we will pull them down now in Jesus. Open your mouth and pull them down. Because the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come and place the blindfolding weapon of the devil to blindfold the hearts of men and women and see the gospel truth. I pray at this time, in the name of Jesus Christ, the blindfolding weapon, I pull you down. I pull you down. The Bible says, then they that gladly receive the word, we're going to pray that the people will receive the word.
Amen.
Penetrate into the hearts of the people. Amen. The word will flow into the hearts of the people. Like it will flow into their hearts. Their hearts will be preached and they will be brought to conversion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And pray that the word will be received. There'll be no hindrance to the flow of the word. The word will be received in the hearts of the people. And it will bear fruit. It will bear fruit. It will bear fruit of conversion. It will bear fruit of salvation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth wide and I will see it. Open your mouth wide and I will see it. The word will be received. The word will be The fire of the Lord will be broken.
Soon, let the hand of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ.
He will convict them. He will transform them.
And people will come to conviction. People will come to conversion. In the name of Jesus Christ, the lives will be transformed by the power of the Lord. By the power of the Lord. By the power of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we look to you by your spirit and your power. Let the water flow. Let the water flow. Let the water flow. Let the water flow. And it will be received. Yes, and it will be a fruit. And it will be a fruit. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
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 People say, is not my word like as a fire? Fire that will burn. It's not my word like a hammer. The hammer that will break. When that the fire of the word on everything contrary to the salvation people, the armor of the word will break every stony heart in Jesus' name. Let's pray right now. Open your mouth and pray. Oh God of glory, the word is quick and powerful. Your word can never fail. It will not return unto your voice. Pray now. And the word of God coming forth, the hammer of the word will break every heart, every act that is resisting salvation, every act that is resisting the way of school, every heart that is resisting the way of salvation. I pray, my God, let the word, the hammer of the word, break every heart, every act of the sinners, break them, break their hearts, so that they will not be able to resist the salvation of the Lord. They will not be able to resist the word of the Lord. They will not be able to resist the way of the Lord. And the fire of the word will burn every property of Satan. Will burn every property of the evil one. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, in the name of the Lord. By the power of the Lord. By the mind of the Lord. By the, for the glory of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. We are praying.
Amen.
Now, the word of the Lord says that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Yes.
Mighty through God. Pulling down strongholds. Casting down imaginations.
Yes.
Come to hear the word of God, there are imaginations.
Mm.
Are invited, there are imaginations. Mm. We pray that every imagination contrary to salvation will be cast down. As the in the word, every imagination, every influence of demons, every influence of powers of darkness, every influence of self, every influence of the devil, imagination that wants to say, don't give your life to Christ now, postpone it a little bit more, and all that, we cast them down now in Jesus. Open your mouth. Every imagination, we cast down every imagination of the devil, contrary to their salvation, that by the power of God, they will come to the saving knowledge of the truth. They will not escape the salvation of the Lord. They will not escape. They will not escape. They will not escape. In the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, the Bible says salvation belongs unto you. I will trust you because you cannot fail. Because you cannot fail. Because you cannot. In the name of Jesus Christ, bring them to your salvation. Bring them to the knowledge of the truth. Bring them to the knowledge of the truth. In the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of God, by the might of the Lord, in Jesus' name, we are
praying.
Amen. Amen. We're going to take authority over the strong man. If a strong man keeps his goods are at peace until a stronger than he comes.
Mm-hmm.
Man over different regions, the strong man over different continents, locations, the strong man over different continents and nations. We want to pull down the strong man and take authority over the strong man and then lose the souls in Jesus' name, because it is written, let my people go that they may serve me. We want to demand the release of the people from the hand of the devil.
Amen.
And your freedom in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Open your mouth and pray.
In the name of Jesus, Father Lord.
Let my people the poor devil has no choice. He's not to release them. He's not to release them. He's strong to release them. I destroy your power. His name of Jesus. Your strong power has a new quality with the authority over you. His name of Jesus. The strong man who will power of the Lord. Yes, the strong man of homosexuality. We destroy your power. In the name of Jesus Christ. The strong power of rebellion and lawlessness. We pray for power. In the name of Jesus Christ. The strong man who will be religion. We pray for power. We resist you. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that people will be liberated. In the name of Jesus. We bind, we take authority over every strong man. We bind, we destroy the authority of the powers of the enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, give the glory, Father.
Oh, Lord.
Let the people live. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, and they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine. We're going to pray. As they are saved, they will be added to the church.
Amen.
So continue in Jesus' name.
Amen.
They will be conserved. They will be preserved.
Amen. Amen.
To continue will be poured out.
Amen.
Oh, pour out the grace to continue. Oh God, pour out the grace to continue. Oh, and pray. As the souls get converted, they will continue.
Amen.
They will continue in the word of the Lord. Open your mouth. For continuity, open your mouth and pray that will be.
Father, in the name
of Jesus, oh, Lord, as we are together, open your mouth and pray. Oh God,
oh
God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God,
oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God,
The church will double as a result of this program. We look up to you because you said you will build your church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And so, Father God, we pray you will multiply your church. You will grow your church as a result of the solution for us. You will grow your church. The people will continue. The people will be vibrant, vibrant Christians, vibrant souls on fire for God. On fire for God. On fire for God. On fire for God. They will serve the Lord. They will serve the Lord. They will serve the Lord. They will continue. They will walk with God. They will be conserved. They will be preserved in the faith. They will love the Lord. We will see the results. We will see the results. Because it is written, in every neighbor there is prophet. We will see the results. Because it is written, in every level there is profit. We will see the result. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's thank God because the Lord has answered us.
And Father,
let's bless him because he has answered the prayer of
us already.
Let's give him praise.
By your spirit, oh God.
Let's magnify the Lord. Let's exalt the name of the Lord. Let's exalt the name. The name of the Lord.
Give them
let's thank him for the many souls that are coming into the kingdom.
Oh,
we see them with the eyes of faith. We see them. We see the multitudes.
Oh, Lord.
We see them with the eyes of faith. Oh, we thank you. We thank you because they were preserved. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. It is done. Amen. Over to you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are praying for nations now. The Bible says that blessed are those who have learned to walk in the region, the celebration of righteousness. For you have come together as the people of God. We want to first and foremost appreciate what God is doing, using our church to do in the nations of the world. This is a global crusade. Let's begin to bless the name of the Lord. Let's thank him for what he is doing. Let's thank him for the light of the gospel that the Lord is taking to all nations through this church. Let's begin to bless his holy name. Let's begin to worship God. Let's begin to thank him. Begin to bless his holy name. Begin to thank him for the vision that he has given to the leadership of the church. Begin to thank him for the power of God that he has manifested. Begin to bless the name of the Lord for the mission that God has given us to us. Begin to thank the God that God is doing greater. Let's begin to lift up his The Bible says, for God is the king of all the earth. Sing to him a psalm of praise. God reigns over nations. God reigns over the nation. God is seated in his holy temple. Let's begin to thank God because he reigns over every nation. Begin to worship him because he's the God of all possibility. He's the God of all Almighty God, all nations shall praise your name. Amen. All nations shall praise your name. Let's sing that song one time. Almighty God, Almighty God, all nations shall praise your name. All nations shall praise your name.
Oh Lord, the European world, in the name of Jesus.
The Bible says, for a great door and an effectual is open unto me, but there are many adversaries. You want to pray against every strong man in every nation that the enemy has raised that says the gospel will not penetrate the nation. I'm telling you,
this. Is there any light of the gospel? Begin on every adversary right now. Begin to call on the name of the Lord and say every adversary against the propagation of the gospel, every adversary against the move of God, in every nation of the heart, from Nigeria to America, let's begin to pray under our feet right now. Let's begin to take authority over there.
Oh Lord, we will declare
a thing and it will come to pass. And then let's begin to pray by every nation.
The direction of the
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We're going to pray this prayer now. We're going to tell the Lord that the Lord will use this revival to open doors of opportunity for Deeperlife Bible Church in every nation of the heart. You know, there are some places where they think the gospel cannot go, where they think we cannot have churches. But by the power of God, this divine solution will be divine solution indeed.
Amen.
Even for the church to be established in every nation of the heart, in the name of Jesus
Christ.
The Bible says in Isaiah 2:2, it says, and it shall come to pass in the last day that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations, everybody say all nations, shall flow unto it, Look at verse 3 now. And many people shall say, go and say, come ye, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways, and he will walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. You want to pray and tell the Lord, through this crusade, the mountain of the Lord's house, of Deeperlife Bible Church, it shall be exalted on the top of the mountain. Begin to tell the Lord, and it shall be exalted above the hill, and all nations shall flow unto him. All nations shall flow unto him. All nations shall flow unto him.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
We worship you. We magnify you. We give you glory, Father.
Amen.
Thank you for all that you have done.
Yes.
Oh Lord, to our leaders that have led us, oh God, in the prayer sessions, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for the manifestation of your power in our lives, O God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you. We worship you, O God.
Yes, Lord.
Give you glory, Father.
Hallelujah.
Lord, for your mercy. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you, O God, mighty Father, that we can rely upon an unfailing God. Oh, a God that will never fail. That's the God that we are serving.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. We are so blessed tonight to have another of our fathers on the line. Our father, our regional overseer from Minnesota, Pastor Akiadeneye, please come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, it's very beautiful to have all of us pray together. How beautiful, how wonderful it is, how blessed it is when brethren pray together. And tonight, the Lord has